welcome back to the channel. It's Lauren. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you're doing well. Today we're gonna be doing just some comfort makeup. I really want to just put on some stuff that I know is gonna work. Honestly, don't have time to like test out new products or wonder if like this product's gonna work for me today or not. Like, we're going for a full face of tried and trues, but also things that make me feel confident and really beautiful. So you've probably seen a lot of this stuff on my channel before, but that means it stands the test of time. I'm also really excited because today's video in part is sponsored by Persona. I'm so excited to be working with Persona. You guys know I love a lot of Persona products, and they are doing a Black Friday sale. The entire site's gonna be 30% off, and this can be a really great time to pick up some products. Honestly, if you haven't picked up the cream blush in Teddy yet, like, what are you doing? You guys know I love this. I love this so much. We're gonna be using that today. I'm also gonna be swatching some things throughout the video and using my favorite products from Persona that I'm sure you've seen at least a couple of times on the channel. The sale is going to be going on from today, Thursday, 11/24 through the 28th. It's while supplies last, and they're also adding on the promotion that with any purchase over $100, you're going to get a free Persona pouch. So this is their little makeup pouch. It's so cute. It's like this dusty rose. It's like a corduroy material. And I feel like for how compact it is, it like holds, it holds surprisingly a lot of makeup in here. It has little pouches inside. And yeah, thank you so much to Persona for sponsoring my video. I really have loved working with them. They're really supportive of my channel. I don't believe my code with Persona works for the sale, but I will have my links down below, which will be affiliate links. So if you shop through those, I will earn a commission. And as always, no pressure, but I do really appreciate it if you're gonna pick some things up. And I'm gonna try to do some swatches, like I said, throughout this video and use some products in action, but let's get into this face because I'm sitting here barefaced. All right, let's prime. Say it with me. We're using the Coconut Smoothie Primer from First Aid Beauty. Oh my gosh. It's getting to the lot. Look at this. I can squeeze. It's almost done. Wow, I've really used this thing up. I feel like I just finished one. You guys know I love this primer. I do have a few others actually though that are working out for me, which is really exciting. Primer is a pretty important step for me. My skin is just temperamental. Let's be real. Like, how product sits changes from day to day and how it kind of feels. So this one I feel like gives me the absolute most consistently great results, and it also controls my oil while still being glowy. I honestly feel like I can make a montage of how many times I've like said good things about that primer on my channel. Of course, for foundation, the Yensa, I'm gonna be going in with a little bit, like a pump and a half. I usually just do a pump, but I've been doing a really good job of actually using my sponge to apply my foundation just to get a better like look, you know? There is a hair in my mouth. Okay, we got it. This is always the foundation I reach for when I have an event, I'm traveling, a party, hanging out with friends. I've just used it for so long that I just know how it works. And sometimes when you know, you do comfort makeup, you just need to know it's gonna turn out okay. I love testing new stuff and trying new stuff and finding new favorites. Like, that's how you find these products that become your comfort products. But it's also just so nice to enjoy stuff you've already tested, enjoy stuff you already love. And I'm pretty sure this is the look I'm gonna be doing tomorrow. I'm not filming this on Thanksgiving, but we are actually gonna host like a little Friendsgiving type thing. We're not going home or anything, but I'm just gonna be with friends and really just hang out, you know, and just chill out. Like, I'm so excited. I've been working a lot and I've really been loving it, but it's gonna be so nice just to hang out and just catch up and chill with everyone. All right, for concealer, I'm keeping it so chill. I'm just using the corrector from Sigma. You can see the pan and see the love for this product. I've actually really been enjoying the Glossier Stretch Concealer lately. I remember it being like dewier than it actually goes on, and I feel like it's staying really nice. It's not making my mascara run like I remember, which is amazing. So I've been loving rediscovering that from my Shop My Stash. I'm keeping my bronzer super chill today. I normally use a cream bronzer, but for fast times, which I feel like usually when I'm doing like comfort makeup, I'm not really taking a ton of time and like sculpting and doing all this stuff. So I'm just using the Kosas bronzer, just adding a little color, a little shape to my face, so that way it's not all just like one color. As much as I hate the way this product smells, it looks nice. It sometimes looks a little red, but other times, and I feel like right now, like it looks really good and I have been enjoying it. Okay, I'm gonna add the tiniest bit of powder, and then we're gonna get into the blush, my fave blush. I'm really just adding this to the center of my face, mostly just so my pores here don't look too big and I get a little bit more longevity out of my makeup. All right, now to the blush. I am gonna be using the shade Teddy today because you guys already know it's my favorite. So I'm gonna swatch everything. I thought that this would be helpful if you're gonna shop the sale, you could see some colors. So that is Teddy. It's a beautiful like rosy brown shade with some warmth, and it's like my easy, could be my everyday go-to blush. I have to like stop myself from using it to use other things. I love it that much. This here is the shade Bubble, which is super pink. I feel like this and also Jam could go for that like cold girl makeup that's like trending right now. This is Jam. It's the newest blush from them. They initially just came out with three, and then they added this fourth one like only a couple weeks ago. And then last over here is a really beautiful red. I find when you blend it out, it kind of has a little bit of pink coming through it, but those are all the blushes that they have in the Dreamstick blushes, and I really do like them. They are super, super creamy and also super easy to blend. I used to just go in with this on my face and that works great, but I've actually been preferring with a lot of my cream products to just add it onto my brush. I have just a little bit here, and I'm telling you, this will go very far. It's super creamy and pretty pigmented, but not overly pigmented. And I love this color. It's so pretty. I feel like it adds some life to my face and some color without being too much. It's really like ideal for me. And I always hit my nose. I just love the way that looks, but I tend to go pretty blush heavy. And then when I have a little left over, I'll go on my forehead and also my chin just a little. Oh, but look at that flush. Look at it. I feel like it's so good too. Like it kind of looks a little bronzy, just like adds health and vitality. It's honestly such a go-to for me when I just want to look great, feel great, and again, know that my makeup's gonna come out. It's like the epitome of the comfort makeup I'm kind of like talking about in this video. For highlighter, we knew it was gonna be the Bobbi Brown because this has been my favorite highlighter all year. I'm just gonna use a little fan brush and just dust it gently on top of the blush. I just love the glow that this gives. It's so like natural looking while still definitely like being there, still being a highlighter. And I especially love it on my nose, and I love it for my eye looks. All right, we have the face done already. I'm gonna zoom us in a little. We are gonna be working on brows now, which you guys already know I'm gonna be using my Persona Swipe Up Brow Gel. I actually have two shades. I do really love warm brown. This one works really well for me. I feel like in regular, in like actual life, but for some reason on camera, it pulls really warm. I mean, it is called warm brown. So I'm actually gonna be using the cool brown today. And I have been using that like more recently in my videos, and I think it looks really good on camera. It still looks good in regular life too, but I feel like I prefer warm brown in regular life. And then I have my camera life with cool brown. So I'm gonna be putting that on my eyebrows. I really quite enjoy this brow gel. I feel like it gives me something pretty natural and really gives like definition to each of my hairs. I'm gonna brush out really fast first just to make sure everything looks good. I always start like at the back half of my brows and then go down when I have the most product, and then I go into the front after I've kind of deposited some of that so it's not too heavy. This gives me definitely that more like hair look, and I really quite like it. I feel like it looks really natural. And it's super easy. Like, I created that so fast, and I feel like it gives me some shape without being too much. And then for the other brow, sometimes I won't go back in straight away, and I'll use what I have in the front, and then I'll re-dip it and use the fact that it has more product in the back half, and then kind of work from there. All right, I think that looks pretty dang good. Sometimes I'll just leave it there, and then other times when I want just a little bit more of a clean look on the bottom, I'll take my brow pencil and just kind of fill in. So there's more of like a straight line, if you will, on the bottom. And I feel like that just makes it a little bit more uniform and gives like more of like a for sure shape. I do not pluck my eyebrows. And so I feel like this step just helps make them look a little bit more groomed, but it's very light. But man, super fast. And I go from like no brows, blonde brows, to like, wow, I can show emotion. This brow gel gives me a good amount of hold, but it doesn't ever feel stiff, which I really like. I'm really excited to do my eye look. I'm gonna be priming with my Sigma base in Sorbet. This is my bae.
I love this color.
Definitely comfort makeup. And I just blend that out with my finger, and I blend it pretty far up because I don't want any like seams, because it does have some color to it. So for my eye look today, I'm pretty sure I'm gonna go neutral, but I am gonna show you some swatches and some close-ups of the two big palettes that Persona has. They do have some like 5 pans that you can buy in kits, I believe, but I really love the bigger palettes. So this is the Identity. I really love this. Now that I'm into neutrals, this is honestly such a workhorse, like everyday type of product. So easy to use. The mattes are really blendable, but still pigmented. The shimmers are smooth and creamy and perfect for, again, like everyday wear, and give you that softer shine that I feel like looks really luxe and high-end and just classic, you know? So that's the Identity palette. And then there's the Identity 2, and this one is more colorful. It has some really beautiful jewel tones in here that are a little more subdued. The shimmers have that, again, really beautiful, soft, shimmery formula that I feel like is really luxe and like high-end to me anyway. It doesn't necessarily have like the sparkles to it, but I find these shimmers to just be really flattering and, again, like expensive looking. So if you're more into color or want some color and jewel tones, the Identity 2 palette could be a good one for you to pick up. I, though, for my comfort makeup, you already knew, I'm gonna go in with the neutrals. You know. Every time I use this palette, I always feel so pretty. I'm gonna go straight in actually with Humble, and I'm gonna be putting this on the outer corner. And then as I have less of it on my brush, I'm gonna blend it in. I love how easy this formula is to work with. It's definitely great for like more neutral, everyday, easy makeup, comfort makeup. And then I'm actually using this Persona brush. I don't know if it is sold separately, but I'm gonna use that, and I'm gonna put Seductive all over my lid, even blending onto where we laid down that outer corner color. I love this shade. You guys know I love my taupey, minky colors, and that's exactly what this is. So freaking pretty. So easy. I don't know if it's like getting older or what, but I do really have an appreciation for shimmer shadows that just look so expensive and just nice on the lids without necessarily the sparkle. Don't get me wrong, I love sparkle. Don't get it twisted. But I can't deny that like for every day, sometimes this kind of lower key shine just has like something breathtaking and understated in like the most sophisticated yet sexy way, if that makes sense. So I'm just putting that all over. And honestly, I would stop the eye look here. Like, I'm tempted because I'm on camera to like do more, but the reality of my life would be this. Like, this is what it would be. So I think I'm actually gonna like try to stay true to it. I'm gonna try to stay true. For my brow bone, I'm gonna go into the Pat McGrath highlighter and just put that on the brow bone. Really, really soft. For my inner corner though, I'm gonna go in with the shimmer, like the light shimmer shade that's in here. It's called Sassy, and that's gonna highlight my inner corner. This just has a nice amount of pigment to it, which is great for the inner corner, but is a little icy for my brow bone. So that's why I use two different colors, if you're wondering. Love that. So pretty. Next, I wanna do some liners. The Persona liners are really great. If you love a creamy pigmented liner that does lock down, they have 4 different colors and they're finally back in stock. They were out of stock for a while. Let me get these swatched for you so I can show you. I already know what I'm gonna use today. All right, so here they all are. They have like a dark, dark black, super pigmented. And these are very, very creamy, let me tell you. This one is the brown. And then my two faves over here, I just think these are so unique. I have a pretty extensive pencil liner collection because they're what I use on my lower lash line and tight line all the time. And this one is plum, which is just beautiful. I feel like it gives me just enough definition while not being too dark, because sometimes these on my eyes and my skin tone and all that can be just definitely intense. Like, they're like a look, and especially not for comfort makeup, not necessarily what I'm doing. And I feel like plum is that perfect balance for me, and it's a cream, so it doesn't have any shimmer. But then there's also bronze, which has a shimmer to it, which I love so much. I thought for sure I was gonna use plum, but now I'm like, should I use copper or plum? I think I'm gonna use copper. I always line just the outer half of my eyes, and then I use my finger to blend out. That's like my favorite way. And I love like the definition without being too dark. And I love a shimmery lower lash line, so we're probably even gonna top this a little. And I'm also gonna bring this onto my upper lash line, a little bit on the tight line. And when I do that, then I'll use a brush and I close my eyes and I just kind of like wiggle. And I'm telling you, once these set, they do really lock down. You know what I'm really hoping that Persona does? I really want like single mono eyeshadows. That would be so great. I would love that so, so much. Like nice shimmery one shadow, like one and done shades. I would love that so much. Look at me just trying to like suggest stuff. I just get so excited whenever they have new stuff. I am gonna top over that liner just with that same color. I went with the copper, which was a little warmer than really the look we were doing. Plum probably would have been a little more cohesive, but I still like it. I'm just like topping over that and blending over it because I just think it looks so good when shimmer's on that lower lash line. I'm gonna add some mascara. This always finishes a look for me. I'm using that Tower 28. Haven't been able to put this down since I got it. Love, love, love it. And then I've just been doing like a tiny bit on the outer corner. And look at that eye look. Just, this is my perfect everyday. I'm gonna zoom you in so you can really see the eye look. So simple, so easy, makes me feel put together and pretty and like it can take on the day, but it's not something I have to like worry about throughout the day, and I love that so much. Oh yeah, I like it. Zoomed out, I like that. Before we move on to lips, I wanna add just like a little bit more blush. I'm genuinely like a blush fiend and I can never get enough. I can never get enough. And I usually do this at the end of my looks. I will just usually tap on a little more blush. I just love that color. For lips, my go-to is like a lip liner and a gloss, and usually like a clear gloss lately. I'm gonna be using one of the Persona lip liners. They have four different colors. I'm gonna give you some swatches. I had to get it together. Okay, this one is 90210. This one is Rosewood. This one's Dusk, and this one's Almond. And I would say Almond and Rosewood are probably my two favorites. I think for today, I'm gonna go with Almond. These liners are super creamy, but I find that they don't necessarily lock down in the way that I don't like from so many other liners. Like one of my pet peeves is that liners that are creamy tend to lock down in a way that feels like thick, and these don't do that. They can be really creamy and I have time to work with them and kind of blend them out and get like a blurred look. I feel like my lip line with these, I can get kind of that almost velvety looking lip line, and sometimes I'll even use like a Q-tip to do that. But I just put some gloss on. This is the Romand lip gloss in number 00 Meteor Track. I really like this. It has a little bit of sparkle to it and it has a little bit of like a cooling plump to it, and that's the look. I have my like slicked back hair today, feeling just cute, clean, still put together, loving the blush, loving the lips, loving the eyes. And I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I'm uploading this on Thanksgiving, so if you celebrate, I hope you guys have a good day and can either get some rest or hang out with friends or family or just loved ones, your chosen family. If that's what you're doing, that's what I'm doing. Again, if you want to shop any of the Persona products, I will have links down below. Thank you again to Persona for sponsoring this video and working with me. And I'd love to know any of your either favorite Persona products down below or any of your comfort makeup items that you love to go to when you just don't have time to fuss around with other things. You want to make sure you look good. You got to get out the door fast. Or honestly, just like want to get that like pumped up good feeling. Sometimes that's what I like to do with my makeup board. And like, I just need to pick me up and want to feel good. I definitely use my comfort makeup for that too. So anyway, thank you guys so much for being here. I appreciate you so, so much. And other than that, I will see you in the next video. Bye guys.